it's all come down to this for the women's heavyweights, the final of the Olympics between the Cuban Idalys Ortiz, who upset the favourite and defending champion Tong Wen, up against Japan's Mika Sugimoto, who beat the Briton Karina Bryant in her semi-final. Division that's been dominated by China at four of the five Olympics. Women have been allowed to compete for the medals. The only other nation who've interrupted their dominance has been the Japanese. Maki Tsukada won this medal in Athens 8 years ago. She went on to take silver in Beijing, where Tong Wen was the champion. But another Japanese fighter ended Tong's reign in the semi-finals. But can Cuba get into the office? If they can, it'll be Idalys Ortiz, who came here as the fifth seed, who'll do it. She got a bronze medal in Beijing. Sugimoto is former world champion. She got it on her home mat in Tokyo 2 years ago. But this is the biggest moment for both of them. Sugimoto in the blue, Ortiz in the white. The women's Olympic heavyweight final.
Ortiz was so impressive in that semi-final. The way that she took the fight to Tong and countered her. Sugimoto, former double world champion, and just got beautiful judo. It's great to watch how the Japanese throws once she gets some movement in the judo, and this is likely to be a faster fight, especially than the last one.
Cuban cheered on as ever by the women's coach, Ronaldo Zaisha, who's done so much to inspire that country. Gentleman in the blue suit. His charge in the white, Idalys Ortiz. A couple of world championship bronze medals down the years. The bronze medal from Beijing, 4 years old now.
Sugimoto threatening, and you can see the Cuban there trying to do the counter. That's this. That's the same technique she used against Tong in the semi-final. Sugimoto knows that she can't do any weak attacks, or she will get countered. Oh, fantastic Sasai there. Used the movement. Takes a Japanese fighter onto his stomach. Not enough to score a Yuko, but a very decent attack.
So Ronaldo barking out the instructions. Ortiz, who overcame a 5-stone weight difference to beat Tong in her semi-final. Much of a difference here. Two fighters pretty well matched.
Sugimoto coming forward, looking to get a grip and create the movement. Good at Tsunata again. Ortiz trying that counter.
Moment worthy of note, by the way, first in this morning inside the XL. First ever woman to represent Saudi Arabia at an Olympics. Woydan Shahirkani looked rather nervously onto the mat, wearing the head covering that had been the subject of so much controversy before these games. Talk she might have to fight without it. If that was to happen, she'd have pulled out, I think. She did wear it and spent plenty of time making sure it was still on when she was thrown through on in the first few minutes of her first fight. So it was a moment of Olympic history, albeit a brief one. Shahirkani, frankly, looking a little overwhelmed by it all. But Saudi Arabian woman can now call herself an Olympian. Two finalists come from Cuba and Japan, who are much more used to contesting the big moments at the end of the day, Nicola Fairbrother.
Yeah, Ortiz now looking, well, both fighters at the moment looking to get their grips. Sugimoto, former double world champion. Both are not wanting to attack until the moment's right. Sugimoto knows the Cuban's waiting for the counter. Pressing twice with it so far.
So the final 90 seconds of normal time, regulation time. Judo contest lasts 5 minutes. The first passivity penalty goes against the Japanese. Warning to step it up a little bit. One more of those and the Cuban will be ahead.
Sugimoto now opening up again. Ortiz getting the first attack through. Into the last minute, the Japanese fighter climbing forward. Got the lapel grip. You can see Ortiz waiting for the attack. The last 9 seconds, will Sugimoto tries it, goes for the big attack. There's no score, and we will go into the golden score if nothing happens in this next 3 seconds.
It does become increasingly hard for the big heavyweights to rekindle the energy as the day goes on. The gaps between the fights get shorter and shorter. It's about conserving energy, and we'll have to find out who's conserved the most for the most important 3 minutes. Perhaps of their lives. Idalys Ortiz of Cuba. Japanese Mika Sugimoto in the blue. 3 minutes. Next score wins the Olympic gold medal.
Well, it's really a matter here of who's going to take the first risk. Is Sugimoto going to be able to get across for that Uchimata, or will she get counter trying it? She's waiting with the grip around the waist. Sugimoto going for it, and there's the counter. Japanese turning it.
Sugimoto from the country that devours the sport of judo. Japan, the one that has dominated the Olympic competition since its debut in Tokyo, 1964. Well, they've won a handful of bronze and silver so far here this week inside the XO. It's not been a vintage Olympic competition for them, just the one gold medal, Kaori Matsumoto. And in Japanese terms, that won't be good enough.
No, they really, really are looking for a gold here. In Beijing, they won 4 golds. They were the dominant country, but they haven't been at this Games.
The rest of the world has certainly caught up the country that gave us this sport over a century ago.
It's been a big surprise, really, because the Japanese women have just been so dominant over the last 2 years. And they've got not only the number one in most weight divisions, they've got the number 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. They've been able to select between the world gold and the world silver medalists in 2 or 3 of the divisions.
Thank you. halfway through this golden score period. If we have no score at the end of the golden score. Dan will be in the lap of the two chair umpires and the referee, who will raise one of two flags. Blue or white, Japan or Cuba. So if they don't want the officials to decide their Olympic fate, they've got to get their skates on here.
Cuba now looking for the turnover.
Mika Sugimoto from Japan.
And to see the Cuban fighter coming back. Good drops here, Nagy. Both fighters now looking for that decisive attack that would take the decision.
If either one of them does give us something in the next 30 seconds, it'll be a moment of their life that they will watch over and over again when they get home and for the rest of their lives, because it'll win them an Olympic gold medal. It's looking increasingly likely that their Olympic fates will be decided by three men raising flags, which has its own drama, but it's not the way that either of these would have wanted it to be concluded, because their fate won't be in their hands and they're 5 seconds away from just that.
Sugimoto still looking here into the closing seconds. Another fight goes to the decision, and now it's the matter of who's done the attack that's got closest to scoring the score. Sugimoto also sitting there with a Judo penalty against her.
So the referee has gathered three sets of flags. She's already given one set to one of the corner umpires, other set to the other. She has one herself. If it's blue, it will be another Chinese Olympic gold. But it's Cuban, it's white. And that's a little piece of history in the heavyweight division. Idalys Ortiz is the first judo player who hasn't represented either China or Japan who can call herself the Olympic heavyweight champion.
Olympic
and she
champion,
gets
Ortiz,
the first
Cuba.
Hug from the great Ronaldo Vaixa, the man who, well, is the heartbeat of the sport back home. And he's not so much of a lightweight himself, is he, old Ronaldo? I think he'd probably appear in this division, but he's got the gold, he's got the flag, and he's got more hugs than he probably knows what to do with, but that's a great moment.
I'm just trying to wonder how many Olympic Games he's been to. It must be six, seven Olympic Games, always there supporting the team. And although Ortiz wasn't brilliant in that match, she was absolutely fantastic against the Chinese in the semi-final, wasn't she?
Yeah, she didn't win it because she beat Tong Wen, the defending champion, in the semi-final, but she will win the popular vote. And, well, the inquest will begin back home immediately in Japan. Just the one gold medal from these Olympic Games. Mika Sugimoto, the latest to fall short. It's the nature of the sport back home. It's like footballers in Brazil, rugby union players in New Zealand. If you think you're the best, you expect the best. And Japan have fallen, not well short, because they've won medals, but they've fallen short here.
Yeah, and what's been a surprise, Nick, is that how they've come out and fought. They haven't fought in the traditional Japanese style. Sugimoto, in the earlier rounds, you could see her firing on all cylinders, going for the big throw, but generally they've come out tactically and it hasn't worked for them.
It's not often that you'll see a Cuban beating a Chinese, but just a Japanese rather, than just seeing it here at the moment. It's most Idalys Ortiz, the Olympic heavyweight champion.